We have gathered together this afternoon for three purposes. The first purpose is to give comfort to the family. On behalf of our community, on behalf of your friends and neighbors and those who live life with Elizabeth, Lorraine, Memaw, Luther, we've gathered together to remind you that you're not alone during your time of grief and bereavement and need. As this community shared life with Lorraine, we continue to walk with you. We've also have gathered together to hold on to our faith beliefs. We may come from a variety of faith backgrounds and traditions, but today we're going to reaffirm the Christian faith. The Bible teaches us that to be absent from this physical body is to be at home with the Lord. Jesus declared, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, even though they die, they shall live again." That was the faith of Lorraine. And so we have gathered together to hold on to all the promises and truths of God. But the third reason that we have gathered together is to remember and to celebrate and to honor a life well lived. She entered life on that September the 20th, 1937. And just a few days ago, the Lord called her home on that November the 8th, 2022. And so we gather together to communicate to Michael and to Jim and to Tracy and to Jeff, to Janet, to her brother Charles, and all these grandchildren and great-grandchildren, other family members and friends. Your life has been touched by her life. And so today we're going to gather together to remember and to celebrate her life. There'll be an opportunity later on in the service, if you would like, to simply stand where you are, or you can come up to the front of the chapel to share your life experiences, your memory, the way that she influenced and continues to impact your life. It's always appropriate to share those family and friends' stories. The music that has been selected were songs very important to her. And so following our prayer time, we're going to listen to the song, In the Garden. May we pray together. Our Father, in this moment of need, the presence of Christ is among us. Today we gather together to mourn because death is a physical loss. It is a social loss. It is an emotional loss. And so we grieve with those who grieve. We walk with them in this journey. But the Christian faith reminds us that we are not alone. We do not walk this journey alone. The Lord, He is our shepherd. A shepherd who loves us, a shepherd who has provided for us in this life, and a shepherd and a savior who has provided for us for all of eternity. And so today in this garden of grief, in this garden of darkness, there is the presence and the light of the Lord. And in your heavenly garden, your children are with you. They are eating from that tree of life. They're eating from that tree of healing and restoration. They're in the presence of the Lord. And today, if we choose, we can be in the presence of the Lord to feel His embrace, to experience His comfort, His love, His amazing grace. And so as Lorraine walked with you in this life and all the gardens that you led her, today she is in that garden of paradise for eternity. Father, bless us this day. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God disclosed. Tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. I'd stay in the garden with him. The night around me is falling, but he bids me go through the voice of woe. His voice to me is calling. Tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. And the joy we share as we tarry, no.
During a time such as this, we turn to each other for words of comfort, words of consolation, words of encouragement and hope. And on behalf of the family, thank you for the way that you have been ministering to them and supporting them, not only today, but in the days and weeks, months, and years to come. But a time like this, we can also turn to God's Word. God's Word provides us comfort and hope and assurance during a time of need. David reminds us that the Lord, he is a shepherd that comes to us and walks with us in the journey of life. The shepherd is a personal shepherd, a shepherd who provides for us, protects us, leads us in the journey of life. David declared, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And yea, though I walk through that valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou hast prepared a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou hast anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. And surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Jesus spoke about God's forgiveness and God's love. God's grace, God's forgiveness, God's love is available and abundant to anyone who calls upon his name. Jesus spoke these words to Nicodemus, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life." Later on in the Gospel of John, Jesus shared this truth with his disciples, with his followers, with Lorraine today. "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, also believe in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. But I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. This family needs to be commended for the way that they provided for and cared for and loved their mom, their Memaw, this sister, friend, and neighbor. It's never a burden to care for those who cared for us in life. It's never a burden to care for those that we love because she loved. A mother's love is something that no one can explain. It is made of deep devotion, of sacrifice and pain. A mother's love is endless and unselfish, and enduring comes what may. For nothing can destroy a mother's love or take her love away. A mother's love is patient and forgiving when all others are forsaking. It never fails or falters, even though there's times her heart may be breaking. It believes beyond believing when the world around condemns. A mother's love glows with all the beauty of the rarest, finest gems. It is far beyond defining. It defies all explanation. A mother's love still remains a secret, like the secret of God's creation. A many splendor miracle man cannot understand, and another wondrous evidence of God's tender, loving hand. One pair of hands, just one pair of hands. Now we have an opportunity to hear from you if you would like. If you have a life memory, a life experience, what Memaw, Lorraine meant in your life. It's always appropriate to gather together to honor, to celebrate, to remember the life of our friend, our loved one, our relative. So if you would like to simply stand where you are to share a life memory, a life experience, what Lorraine meant in your life. Are there those who are here today that just like to simply stand and share with us? You all must be Baptist. Anyone, this is your opportunity to share with the family. When death comes, and it does come, it comes to every family, it comes to every individual. When death comes, it is an opportunity for us to reevaluate our lives and to make sure that we have the right priorities in our lives, to make sure that we are in right relationship with each other, to make sure that family is a priority, to be the first one to reach out to each other, to be the first one to say, "How are you?" To be the first one to say, "How can I help you?" To be the first one to say, "I love you, I care for you." When death comes, it is not only an opportunity for us to reevaluate life and our priorities and our family relationships, it is also an opportunity for us to evaluate the relationship that we have with our Creator, to know that it was the hands of Christ that reached out to us to provide us love. It was the hands of Christ that was crucified on the cross to provide us grace and forgiveness. And so it is always an opportunity to honor the person's faith, but also to remember our faith. When death comes, it is also an opportunity for us to evaluate our life choices, our decisions. Lorraine's life has come to an end, but your life continues as you live with her memory, her honor, what she has modeled and given to you. And so today we gather together to honor her life, honor her faith, honor the family that she loved. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. Grace.
sun. We've no less days to sing God's praise than when we first begun. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me.
A lawyer stood up to test Jesus and said, "Jesus, what must I do to inherit this eternal life that you're talking about?" Jesus said to the lawyer, "You know the law. You know the prophets. What does it mean to you? How do you understand it?" And the lawyer said, "Thou shalt love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, and with all your might. Do this, and you shall live." Jesus said, "You have answered correctly. Do this, and you shall live." But wanting to justify himself, the lawyer said to Jesus, "Who is my neighbor? Who is my neighbor?" And in the parable of the Good Samaritan, Jesus defined for us who our neighbor is. There's a man who traveled from Jerusalem to Jericho, and he fell among the thieves. And they beat him, and they robbed him, and they stripped him of everything that he had, leaving him half dead. But by chance, a priest came along, a priest who worshiped God and made a vow to serve God's people. He saw the man in need, heard his cries, but passed by on the other side. Likewise, a Levite in the church walked by, saw the man in need, heard his cries, but passed by on the other side. But a Samaritan, someone who was not considered worthy to worship God or to serve his people, the Samaritan saw the man in need, heard his cries, got down off his animal and ministered to him, bandaged up his wounds and poured that healing oil and wine upon him, put him on his own beast and took him to Jericho and took him to that inn and told the innkeeper, "Take care of my friend, and whatever it cost, I will repay when I come again." Then Jesus said, which demonstrated love to his neighbor? And the lawyer said, the one who showed mercy. The world doesn't need more priests or more Levites today. The world needs more Samaritans, people who help, people who care, people who sacrifice, people who give. People who stop their life to meet the needs of your life. And that's the type of life and faith that Lorraine lived and demonstrated each and every day. She lived a full and rewarding life. The mother of seven children, two have passed. And what a loss she must have experienced over the years. But yet her faith and her love for you and for the Lord kept her going. She was a risk taker. She moved to California at a very young age, and she worked at Disneyland in housekeeping. She had a family in California and later on a second family. Then she moved back to Roanoke. Although she had two families, she had one family. She had you. Lorraine was a Memaw to everyone. She was loving and caring and a wonderful person. She was a joy to be around. And you can tell that by the pictures that are in the lobby, in the foyer, pictures all around, that family was her priority. You were her pride and joy. She was proud of the accomplishments of all of her children. When you excelled and achieved, she excelled and achieved. And then as she watched her children grow up and she watched her children have relationships with their spouses, and then the grandchildren started rolling in. And then the great-grandchildren rolled in and rolled in and rolled in. But she was simply called Memaw by just about everyone in her family. She had a variety of hobbies and interests, but work and family were the priorities. Whether she was waitressing in restaurants or working at the bowling alley and even bowling herself. The goal of a bowler is to bowl that perfect game, that 300. Everyone wants strikes. Everyone wants all the pins to fall down. I'm sure she has experienced her number of strikes, her number of spares, but also her numbers of splits and leaving a pin or two. And there's times that even the best bowlers, you bowl a gutter ball. But you don't quit. You don't give up. You keep living. You keep trying. You keep moving forward. Her family remembers her as just a joyful person to be around, and particularly her cooking, her coleslaw, that homemade potato salad. The holidays are among us, and this family, you'll go through the series of first. The first Thanksgiving, the first Christmas, the first New Year, the first birthdays, the first anniversaries. And it is a time of sadness. It is a time of grief. But there will come a time when your grief, your crying, will turn into a smile, a laughter, a memory, a wonderful memory. You may have experienced one of her mean card-playing times or board games or listening to her stories. Cherish those memories. Hold on to those memories. Memaw was a giver. She was a caregiver. She also provided child care for many of her grandchildren and great-grandchildren. Raise your hand if she kept you and watched you, nurtured you and loved you. Raise your hand if she didn't spare the rod from time to time. There are many scripture verses that teach us how to live a Christian life, a godly life. But there's one particular scripture text found in the Old Testament, tucked away in the minor prophet called Micah 6:8. The Lord told Micah, and the Lord is teaching us, He has shown you, O man, O woman, what is good and what the Lord requires of you, to live a life of justice. Treat people with respect and fairness and kindness. Treat people with equality. Treat people with love, and never judging them. He has shown you, O man, what is good and what the Lord requires of you, to live justly. She attempted that and she tried that and she succeeded in living a just life. A mother's heart, a mother's spirit, a mother's mind, a Memaw's soul and spirit contains many secrets. You confided in her and she shared her wisdom, her knowledge, her kindness. God reminds us the imperative to live a just life. God also reminded Micah and us today to love mercy. To love mercy. Mercy is forgiveness that we do not deserve. Mercy is forgiveness that we cannot earn. Mercy must come from God. And those who receive that amazing grace, that amazing mercy, are commanded or called to give mercy, grace, and forgiveness to others. He has shown you, O man, what is good and what the Lord requires of you, to live justly, to love mercy, and to walk humbly with the Lord. Not drawing attention to yourself, not living a life of pride, not boasting, but living a meek life, a humble life, a life that others can find example in, a role model. Today we gather together to acknowledge that death has occurred. Your mom, your Memaw, has traveled down the road a little further than we have today. But she has walked that path of justice. She has lived that life of mercy. She has demonstrated a life of humility, walking humbly with the Lord, walking humbly with you each and every day. She may have left our physical presence, but thanks be to God, she has never left the presence, the sight of the Lord. Well done, good and faithful servant of the Lord, Elizabeth Lorraine Memaw Luther. Enter into the joy of your eternal rest. May we pray together. Our Father, we thank you so much that the Lord, He is with us. The Lord is our shepherd, and His children have no needs or wants, because our wonderful shepherd provides for us in this life. He provides for us when we walk through that valley of the shadow of death. And the Lord provides for us for all of eternity a table prepared by the Lord Himself, where He anoints our head, He heals every infirmity, every disease, every hurt, where there's no more pain, there's no more suffering, there's no more death. And the Lord welcomes us into His home, into the mansion that He has prepared for all of eternity. Father, as you have walked with Lorraine throughout her earthly life, you continue to be that wonderful shepherd that walks with us today. Father, surround this family with your peace, with your presence, and the comfort of the Lord. In His holy name we pray. Amen. Our service will conclude at Blue Ridge Memorial Gardens. May God bless you today.